Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create polyscapes. Polyscapes are essentially photo effects that merge beautiful landscapes or scenes with geometric shapes using clipping masks and shape tools. There are limitless possibilities of designs for polyscapes, but for the most part, they all use the same basic technique to create them. Before we begin, if my tutorials have helped you learn or improve in Photoshop, please consider supporting my channel by becoming a patron. For as little as $2 a month, you can help me keep my tutorials free. Click the Patreon button at the upper right or the Patreon link in my video's description below. Any amount you can pledge is greatly appreciated. For this particular polyscape design, we'll use two photos. I downloaded both of them from Shutterstock. Find two horizontal photos that you'd like to use for this project. Begin with a photo that we'll use for your background. We'll convert it into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively and adjust the effects at any time. It'll also allow us to replace the photos with others without having to redo the effects. To do this, click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel and click Convert to Smart Object. Make a copy of it by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Temporarily hide the copy and make the original layer active. We'll create a soft dark vignette around the outside edges of our image. Go to Filter and Lens Correction. Click the Custom tab and slide the vignette all the way to the left. Then click OK. I'd like to adjust my background's brightness and color cast. If you want to do the same for your background, click the adjustment layer icon. If you're using Photoshop CS6 or later, click Color Lookup. If you're using an earlier version, you can experiment with Hue Saturation or Color Balance or Channel Mixer. Open Load 3D LUT and cycle through the filters to choose the effect you like. I'm using Crisp Winter Look. For this image, the filter is a bit too intense, so I'll reduce its opacity to 40%. We'll convert our image into a smart object by shift-clicking layer 0 to make it active as well as the adjustment layer, and converting them into a smart object. Let's name it Base and the copy Ring. Make the base layer active and click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. Inside this empty layer, we'll create our first shape. Open the Polygon tool and choose Shape. If you're using CS5 or earlier, the Shape tool is here. Click the Fill box. The fill color is the color of the shape. However, since we'll be filling the shape with a photo, the color doesn't actually matter in this instance. For now, click Black. Click the Stroke box and click the white box with the red diagonal line in it. This is the box to click when you want no fill or no stroke. The pixel amount in this field determines the width or thickness of the stroke. However, we won't be needing it for now, so the amount is irrelevant. Later, we'll make a shape using a stroke with no fill, which is essentially an outline. Make the number of sides 3. Click the gear icon and make sure star is unchecked. Then press Enter or Return. Next, we'll create guidelines to locate the exact center of our document. Open View. If you're using version CC or later, click New Guide Layout. If you're using an earlier version, I'll show you what to do in a moment. Make sure columns and rows are both checked, and the number for both is 2. If you're using a version earlier than CC, click New Guide. In either orientation, type in 50% for the position. Then click OK or press Enter or Return. Go back to View, New Guide, tick the other orientation, and type in 50% again. Go to the center of the guidelines and press and hold Shift as you drag down the Shape tool a bit below the bottom of your image, then release. To slide the shape up, press V to open your Move tool, and press and hold Shift as you drag it straight up to approximately here. Open your other photo and drag it up onto the tab of your background image. Without releasing your mouse or pen, drag it down and release. Go to Layer 1 and drag it down above the shape you made. We're going to mask the photo so it'll show only through the inside of the shape. To do this, we'll make the photo into a clipping mask by pressing Ctrl-Alt-G on Windows or Command-Option-G on a Mac, or you can go to Layer and click Create Clipping Mask. Position the photo inside the shape by just dragging it. We can resize the photo by pressing Ctrl or Command T to open your Transform tool. Go to a corner, and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it out or in. Continue to position and size it to your liking. Then press Enter or Return. To temporarily hide the guidelines, press Ctrl or Command H. Make the shape layer active and click the FX icon. Click Stroke. Make the size 9 pixels and the position inside. The blend mode is Linear Dodge and the opacity is 50%. The fill type is Gradient. Click the gradient bar to open the gradient editor. For this example, let's click this preset called Spectrum. Then click OK on both windows. Notice the subtle but thin strokes surrounding our shape. We'll place our shape and corresponding photo into a folder by shift-clicking the photo to make it active as well and pressing Ctrl or Command G. Make a copy of it and drag the copy to the right. Open the top folder and make the shape active. Go to Edit, Transform, and Flip Vertical. Notice the shape flipped, but not the photo inside the shape. That's because only the shape is active. Open your Transform tool, and using the same steps, drag it in to approximately this size. Position it to approximately here, and press Enter or Return. Make the photo active, and drag it to a position you like inside the shape. Close the folder, and make a copy of it. Open this folder, and make the shape active. Press and hold Shift as you drag across the second copy to a position that's equidistant as the right shape is from the center shape. To reposition the photo inside this shape, make the photo active and drag it. If you want to resize the photo, use your Transform tool. To see the Transform's entire bounding box, press Ctrl or Command 0. Resize and reposition it inside the shape to your liking. To zoom back into it, press Ctrl or Command and the plus key once or twice. Close the folder and name it Left Shape. Name the middle folder Right Shape and the bottom folder Center Shape. Make the Left Shape folder active and click the New Layer icon to make a new layer above it. In this empty layer, we'll create another shape, but this time it'll be a thin circular outline. Let's zoom out to 50%. Make the guidelines visible again and open your ellipse tool. Click the fill box and click the no fill icon. Click the stroke box and click black. Make the width 10 pixels. Click the gear icon and make sure proportional is ticked and from center is checked. Go to the center and drag out the circle almost to the edge of your canvas. Then release. Make the top layer visible and active. Clip it to the shape under it. I'd like to give the image inside of the ring more complexity, so I'll flip the image. If you'd like to do the same, go to Edit, Transform, and Flip Vertical. Open your Transform tool and enlarge the photo inside the ring approximately this much. Hide the guidelines and zoom back in. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.